this case, again, it's a Zugzwang. You have to move your king away, so I take that moment. This is a very famous composition. Basically, white captures a position and waits for black to go to the b file first. Just because of the position. That's basically how this endgame is played. Oh, actually, maybe in this case, king d5 is working also. Ah, no, it's not. Yeah, knight d7. So we always keep a position to come close. This is a very complicated example. So sometimes you even have a position when it's not so obvious, we don't really advance forward, we advance to the side. Because there is one position in the future where we want work to have a move. And that's why we keep a position all the time. Because if you move first, then we have to move. And wake up your position, and it's going to be a draw. So, there are also situations where you have extra pawn, but with multiple pawns, but this pawn is on, these pawns are on one side. In this case, you cannot distract like you had this, like you have it like this. You basically just distract my king, when you come closer, and you take all the pawns. This is very simple, because pawns are on this side, you want to make a passed pawn. So usually you do it by advancing your pawns. In pawn game, anyway, like even though we have multiple pawns, the most important thing you have is your king. You should try to push it as more as you can. For example, in this position, how would you start? You can make such move, but as I said, I would firstly recommend you to improve your king. Because you can push your pawns late. There is no reason for you to start push pawns. Yes, king e4 is fine. I will go king e6. I mean, our fight is on king's side. You don't really need to go this way. I mean, now you're blocking your pawn. Again, Joshua, can you go forward with your king? No, you cannot. So now you can advance your pawns. G4 is fine, okay. In general, I would recommend you make pawns, so I would not be able to block them. For example, now after g4, I can go g5. Mm-hmm. And always, this pawn is blocked.
Yeah, always goes extra first. It's extra. You have extra. This extra, you mean? No. See? These two equal, right? On the same profile. This first.
Yes, yeah. Exactly.
That's
exactly
a book set, you know?
Yeah, but.
Yeah.
So it's better to start with f4.
Yeah.
Because basically.
Because, you know, these two, you can block him, but this one, he can't block. Go for this.
Yes, exactly.
The extra
first. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Basically, what's the point? You need to make a passed pawn. To make a passed pawn, you definitely need to exchange one pair of pawns, right? You cannot make a pawn so it will without exchanging g pawns. For this reason, you want to advance them and exchange the pawn. Basically, if you do it like this, then I will go g5.
Mm-hmm.
You can still exchange the pawn,
yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you're not creating a passed pawn.
Mm-hmm.
We just got to station where you have 2-1.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Keep in mind, if you play, that's actually very important advice for all positions in general. If you have advantage, if you have material advantage, you should not exchange pawns. Because if you exchange pawns, it's easier for your opponent to make a draw. So f4 is fine. Let's assume I go g6. you can go to 2 files. Yes, very good. Okay, let's assume I go like d6. is. How would you consider it? In this case, f5 would be blocked. It will be harder for you to improve in this position. I mean, it's still winning, but I just don't recommend you to go like this. Keep in mind, your pawns already block my king. And I don't really have a move. Yes, you can try to push your king a little bit further. Because now, if I go g5, how would you continue? Exactly. And now your position is absolutely winning, because your king just comes closer.
Same, yeah.
When you play like f6, f5, you take the pawn. If he blocks you like this, go h3. And then you can take the pawns. So this is absolutely winning. So I probably have to go back. And how will you continue? Yes, very good. I mean, you're not making any progress if you go like this. Try to create a passed pawn. Joshua, it's better not to move this pawn at all. You don't really need it at the moment. At some moment you might play, but keep in mind, like in pawning games, where it's quite common that you have situation of Zugzwang, when you need to get a position. When you have a pawn that you can move, you can basically give your opponent a turn, and that's how you win, because you get a position because of it. So if you have pawn on h2 and you can just play without moving, it would be better for you.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, your mechanism to win is very simple. Just make a passed pawn.
Yeah.
Yes, you just go f5. Yeah. I have to take because otherwise you go f6.
So he take it, then you take it.
Yeah, we exchange. Now. Yes. Keep in mind, again, in a normal pawn in the game, this is just one pawn, it would be a draw.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's not because you have extra pawn and you can use it.
Mm-hmm.
First and very simple way to use it,
mm-hmm.
just go king f6.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, now it's not a stalemate because
mm-hmm.
I have a pawn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If
yeah.
I go h5, how do you win?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That's okay. Just nothing more, Joshua. That's okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, you just go h3.
So now this.
Because
this,
now I have to move my king away.
Yeah, why move
you
this?
Blocked
because,
my...
because you want to move that piece. Let him move that. Otherwise, he can still move one step.
Yes.
Then you have moved this, then he will take you.
Yes, exactly.
Home. So you just block here. Then, you know, now he almost, you're almost trapped over there. Just in the one move. Let a queen move here, other side. Then
yeah, you just
here.
Make
then
it
you promote.
Everything is
you
very
know?
Simple.
You need to just move, yeah.
And that's actually why...
Kick out his king, you know?
That's actually why it was important for you to have pawn on h2.
Then move.
Because assume you would do exactly the same, but you firstly played h4. You did not pay enough attention.
Mm-hmm.
You played h4. What happens now? You go f7.
Mm-hmm.
Go king f8.
Mm-hmm.
Go king f6.
Mm-hmm.
Now go h6.
Mm-hmm.
It's a draw.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I go
h5.
So you either take the pawn and you, I take the pawn and it's
as a stalemate.
See, Joshua, this was actually why it was very important for you to have pawn on h2.
So don't move anything.
The,
okay.
Yeah, but if especially on h2, keep in mind, in pawn and games, if you have situation that you have like extra pawn and you do anything, if you have pawn on h2, it's just brilliant to have this.
Mm-hmm.
исполненный H2, you can go as a H3 or H4.
Mm-hmm.
And in most cases, it's very important because you can choose like
mm-hmm.
how to move it. I will show you an example.
Mm-hmm.
Assume you have pawn on H3.
Mm-hmm.
So can you put my, I have pawn on H7,
mm-hmm.
but can do exactly the same.
I'll escape that language.
Okay, assume you now go F7, king F8, king F6.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's also there because I go H5. Yes, and I go H4. You see what happened? Like, if your pawn is on H3, I go H5. If you go pawn is on H4, I go H6. It was literally no option for you. For this reason, if pawn is here, as I understand, you can't still win. It's just harder for you. You should go... Actually, maybe it's not a win already. I have to say. Yes, actually, it's probably a draw already. So you had to have your pawn on H2 for this.
Mm-hmm.
There are many examples where actually having pawn on H2 is essential. For example, assume you have endgame like this. And it's just a moment. Assume it's white to move now. This is actually a very good example why pawn on H2 is so essential. On a second rank, not the second H2. Go away, you will just make a draw. Joshua, the only way you can win in this position, the only thing you can do. You can push this pawn to H5,
mm-hmm.
then you can go
and
G6.
Trade the pawn.
Yeah, and when you take this pawn,
then,
so you get a position.
Yeah,
that's
mm-hmm.
only thing how you, only way how you can win.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, what happens if you have pawns on H3 and G3,
mm-hmm.
your pawns can move just one move at a time. They can only do one move. And basically, now I can calculate
mm-hmm.
where you are going to end.
Mm-hmm.
And there is no way for you to trick me. Because I know that after king h6, my king should be on g8.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's a draw because you move, I move,
mm-hmm.
you move, I move. There is no way for you to change it.
Mm-hmm.
Because you move just one step at a time.
Mm-hmm.
For example, assume you would have it would go like h4.
Mm-hmm.
Now if my king would end up on g8 after king h8, you would be winning. For example, if you go king f8, now you are winning. g4,
mm-hmm.
king h8, g5, king g8, h5, king h8, g6, h takes g6, h takes g6.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a position. So I know that after king h8, h6, where should my king be, Joshua? After you play king h6, where should I put my king? No. Where should be my king to have a position?
His king.
Here.
His king.
Should be on h8. Because if I go on g8, you will push your pawns and we will end up in this position. I want to have this position, so I take and make a draw.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand, Joshua? And that's basically why in many pawn games like this, if at least one pawn is on second rank, it's absolutely winning. Because now, what happens? Go g5, king h8. Joshua, now you have two options. You can go either h3 or h4.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yes, and you win. Now tell me what would happen if it's right to move here. Joshua, now you make a draw. Because I go king h8. Yes, exactly. And now I cannot escape because you go to the twist position, and when you calculate, you figure out if you need to move pawn one move at a time or two moves.
Mm-hmm.
Very good, Josh. Yeah. And now you win. There is another very classical example. Okay. So my pawn is going this way. So your pawn white. Theo, how do you make it go here? This way.
Control.
Yes. I can give you a hint. This king is stuck here, so, and you can block it by playing king c2 or king c1. And basically, knight will come to try to attack you. But you will still be moving. One, if you make a correct move, then you will make a draw in this position. Yes, this is a draw. Basically, white had it. In pawning game, you know that pawns are moving just one step at a time. So it's very simple to calculate like, who is going to win that position if you have to move pawns. In this case, we have another interesting phenomenon because knight cannot actually lose a tempo.
Mm-hmm.
Because it moves like this.
Mm-hmm.
It has one interesting property. It can only move to the color of the opposite to where it stays.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, if knight stays on a white color,
mm-hmm.
it can only, in a black color, it only can go to a white color.
Mm-hmm.
Again, if knight is on white color, what it means? It can only attack the dark color.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And basically, what you need, the only thing you need to do, you should just put your king the same color as knight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you accidentally make a right move out of two, but mm-hmm. this move is correct because now I cannot do anything to you.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, if you think about it, your king is on c1, so your next move, what would be your next move? Because you need to block the king.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your next move would be king c2. So you are going to a white square.
Mm-hmm.
So your next move is white square.
Mm-hmm.
If black knight is on a dark square,
mm-hmm.
it should go to the white square. And from the white square, it cannot control white square. It
mm-hmm.
can only control dark square.
Dark square, yeah.
So that's why knight would be like checking around,
mm-hmm.
but it will never do anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. This pawn can
move. No. It's going this way.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
That's the point.
I see. Okay. Mm-hmm.
So it's quite a good example for...
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in this case, not in a position, like in chess, besides position, you also have a thing, I think in English it's called something like, how to say it, basically it means that like one field is related to the other field,
mm-hmm.
like it's like a position, but sometimes it's on a different squares,
mm-hmm.
like in this case it's like knight and king.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So dark square to the dark square in general.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In this case, when we had it человека, отличного квиз. It was a position in the future, which matters. And you can easily calculate it to the end. Just a moment. Why it go in this way? Why to move? Joshua, but he was winning. Starting position, you win.